The TSA is also changing security rules for passengers, including much more aggressive pat-down searches for those who opt out of the new full-body image scanners or those who get chosen for them. It's all getting decidedly mixed reviews from travelers. Our report tonight from NBC's Tom Costello.
If you leave items in your pockets, you may be subject to additional screening.
It's the latest tactic in the TSA's ever-evolving approach to aviation security. Full-body scanners able to peer underneath clothing. And for passengers who opt out of the scan, a much more personal full pat-down, with officers now using the front of their hands and more vigorously searching for weapons and explosives. The TSA chief says it's a direct response to Al-Qaeda.
We believe this provides the best possible technology to identify those non-metallic improvised explosive devices that we know have been used before.
The challenge for the TSA, searching those private areas of the body most considered off-limits, but have been used by criminals and terrorists to hide drugs, weapons, and explosives. Most recently by the underwear bomber who nearly brought down a Delta Northwest flight last Christmas. The full-body scanners obscure passengers' faces.
That's something I would call.
While a screening officer in another room has but a few critical seconds to look for anything suspicious. The TSA uses two different types of imaging technology called backscatter and millimeter wave. Right now, 317 units are in use at more than 65 airports nationwide. Millimeter wave uses radio waves to peer under the clothes, while backscatter systems use X-ray technology.
Christmas Day last year was an awakening call.
It's all critical technology, says the former head of security at Israel's Ben-Gurion Airport. But identifying unusual behavior, then thoroughly questioning travelers who stand out, is just as critical.
You may not know during the interview that the terrorist is actually a real terrorist, but what you will know is that that person is lying.
For travelers, the security over privacy trade-off often comes down to gender. Men, less offended.
It's what we have to do to travel these days, so it is what it is.
Women, more.
It's just personal space, invasion of my personal space, my body.
I understand why it's needed. However, you know, from a personal standpoint, it is an invasion of privacy to an extent.
And 2 million people moving through TSA checkpoints every day. Tom Costello, NBC News, Denver.